हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय ग्रामर क्लास। टुडे वी आर हियर टू लर्न प्रेपोजिशंस। सो लेट्स राइट द डेट फर्स्ट। टुडे इज 29/10/21 एंड ऑन द रेड लाइन वी आर गोइंग टू राइट द टॉपिक दैट इज प्रेपोजिशंस। PREPOSITIONS prepositions. Now, what are prepositions? Let's write its definition, children. Then we will come to your test book. Everybody will write along with me. Say and write, children. Leave the first line. Start from the second line. Preposition PREPOSITIONS. I repeat, PREPOSITIONS. It will be preposition because we have written a. Okay, a preposition is a word, word, word that connects, connects, that connects nouns, comma, pronouns, and phrases, PHRASES, phrases to the other, OTHER, other words in a sentence. Full stop. Okay, repeat after me, children. A preposition is a word that connects nouns, pronouns, and phrases to the other words in a sentence. So basically, it is a connecting word. Okay, that is a connecting word which connects pronouns, nouns, and phrases with the other words that is given in the sentence. Okay, children, you don't have to learn this. This is just for your reference. Okay, before we do anything, we should know the definition. So I have given you this. This is only for your reference. Okay, now let's see. Come to your test book. That is on page number 17, I suppose. Open page number 17, children. 16 and 17, yes. Prepositions are given at page number 16 and 17. So, can you see some pictures given in page number 16? That is for the explanation. Okay. Under, over, in, on, in front of, behind, next to. You can refer your book for these words. Okay, so all these are called prepositions. Now, what are these words going to do? These words are going to connect nouns and pronouns with the other words given in the sentence. I repeat, the words are under, over, in, on, in front of, behind, and next to. This much prepositions are given in your book. Okay. In other words, you can write preposition, write it here. Preposition showing position. Okay, we are going to do the preposition which shows position. That is under, over, in, on. We will all this understand while doing the sentences, okay? In front of, behind, next to, and all. Now we come to page number 17, where the question is given, okay? Let's write the question, children. The question is B. Okay, B question. What is the question? Look at the picture. The picture is given in your book at page number 17. Look at the picture. I'm writing the whole question so that you will not get confused. Then choose the right words in the sentence. Okay, so options are given in the sentence. We have to choose the correct one. Okay, what is the first sentence given? The first sentence is, number one, Carla is hiding in the bracket, it is written UNDER under slash behind BEHIND bracket close the tree TREE okay. Carla is hiding under behind the tree. Now what do you mean by hiding? We play a game hide and seek, remember? That is what we call as hiding, chupna. Okay, we call it as chupna in Hindi. What is under? Under means niche. Behind, what do you mean by behind? Piche, kisi cheez ke piche, that is called behind. Now before doing any sentence, you have to observe the picture carefully. Observe the picture in your book given at page number 17. Now can you see a girl who is hiding behind the tree? So when you hide behind something, piche. If you are standing in front, agar aap saamne mein khade ho, you can not hide, right? So if you want to play hide and seek and you want to hide, then you have to go behind something, right? So Carla is hiding behind the tree. Because she wants to hide, so she has to go behind. That is piche, right? So the correct word here is behind. So put a tick mark over here. You cannot go under the tree. Can you go under the tree? Huh? The roots are below, inside the soil. So we cannot go under the tree. So the answer has to be behind only. Carla is hiding behind the tree. Okay. Behind means piche. Under means niche. Okay. Now we come to the second one. Number two is, write number two in the margin. A boy, what is given in your book? A boy is standing, S-T-A-N-D-I-N-G. A boy is standing, in the bracket it is given, behind. I told you the meaning of behind, slash, in front of, F-R-O-N-T, in front of means samne, behind is piche and the opposite of behind will be in front of, that is samne, the tree, T-R-E-E, tree. Now observe the picture, can you see a boy standing, dash the tree, what you have to do in the dash, behind or in front of? Now, one is Carla, that is behind the tree. And where is the other boy standing? He is standing in front of, samne, right? Why Carla is behind? Because she is hiding. Now, this boy is not hiding and so he is standing in front of, samne, in front of the tree. So, mark in front of, that is the correct answer here. Now, we come to number 3. And the third one is, it's again a boy. Write it with me, children. A boy is climbing, C-L-I-M-B-I-N-G, climbing. Bracket start, up, dash, down, bracket close, the ladder, L-A-D-D-E-R, dash the ladder. Now, children, here the word is climbing. Many a times you confuse with the word climbing. Climbing means going up. No, climbing can be going up also. Climbing can be going down also. When you go up with the stairs, we say climbing up the stairs. When you come down with the same stairs, we call it as climbing down the stairs. So, very first thing, be clear. Climbing doesn't mean only going up. Climbing means going up also. It can be coming down as well. Okay? Climbing up or down. So, what is here? A boy is climbing dash the ladder. Now, what is given in your picture? Just check it out. In the picture, the boy is climbing up, right? He is going upward. So, we are going to mark UP up and the answer will be a boy is climbing up the ladder. Okay? Now, we come to the next one, that is number 4. Number 4 is another boy, A-N-O-T-H-E-R, another boy is coming, again in the bracket it is up slash down, bracket close. The slide, S-L-I-D-E. Now, look at the picture and you will find that the boy, that is another boy, is coming down the slide. Okay, when we come to slide, generally it will be coming down only because you cannot climb up on a slide. It is difficult to do that. Okay, slide is for coming down only. Okay, so look at the picture. The boy is also coming down. So the answer is D-O-W-N, down here. Now we come to the next one, that is number 5. And the fifth one is the kite. K-I-T-E, kite is flying. F-L-Y-I-N-G. Flying, in the bracket it is over slash under, bracket close, the bushes, B-U-S-H-E-S, bushes. Okay, the kite is flying over under the bushes. Now, what do you mean by under? Under means niche. Can a kite fly under the bushes? Niche? No. So, children, when it comes to flying, it should be always over. Okay. So, the answer here will be over. The kite is flying over the bushes. And what do you mean by over? That is up. Then you will say on also? No. On, it is on when it is touching something. And over is something which does not touch the thing, right? When it is flying, it will never touch the bushes, right? So that is what we call as over. Okay? If the kite is kept on the bushes, then we will say on the bushes. The kite is kept on the bushes, but it is not kept, it is flying. And when it is flying, that means it will not touch it. And that is what we call as over. Okay? That is, there has to be some space between the thing and the bushes, the kite and the bushes. Then we will say, the kite is flying over the bushes. Got it, children? Now we come to number 6. Number 6 is a boy. Is holding, H-O-L-D-I-N-G, holding the kite, apostrophe S, kite's string, S-T-R-I-N-G, string is the thread, right? We call also call it as thread. But the correct word for it is string. A boy is holding the kite's string in the bracket in, on, bracket close, his hand. So children, when you hold something in your hand, when you hold it, that is inside. So we will say in the hand. Okay, if you are opening your hand like this, it will be on. But when it comes to string, that then it has to be inside. Okay, so we'll mark in here. So the sentence will be, a boy is holding the kite's string in his hand. Got it? Now we come to number 7. And number 7 is, there is a man sitting, S-I-T-T-I-N-G, sitting, in the bracket, it is on, / in, a bench. Okay, I'm going to write a bench here itself, a bench. Okay, so when you sit on anything, you always sit on. As I told you here, when something is kept, it is on, and when it is not touching the thing, then it is over. So when you are sitting on a bench, then you are touching the bench, right? And then we say it is on. There is a man sitting on the bench. You can refer the picture. There is a man sitting on the bench, right? We never say in the bench. In means inside. For example, if I keep this pencil on my hand. So children, when it comes to flying, it should be always over. Okay. So the answer here will be over. The kite is flying over the bushes. And what do you mean by over? That is up. Then you will say on also. No. On. It is on when it is touching something. And over is something which does not touch the thing, right? When it is flying, it will never touch the bushes, right? So that is what we call as over, okay? If the kite is kept on the bushes, then we will say on the bushes. The kite is kept on the bushes, but it is not kept, it is flying. And when it is flying, that means it will not touch it. And that is what we call as over, okay? That is, there has to be some space between the thing and the bushes, the kite and the bushes. Then we will say the kite is flying over the bushes. Got it, children? Now we come to number 6. Number 6 is a boy is holding, H-O-L-D-I-N-G, holding the kite, apostrophe S, kite's string, S-T-R-I-N-G. String is the thread, right? We call also call it as thread. But the correct word for it is string. A boy is holding the kite's string in the bracket in, on, bracket close, his hand. So children, when you hold something in your hand, when you hold it, that is inside. So we will say in the hand. Okay, if you are opening your hand like this, it will be on. But when it comes to string, that then it has to be inside. Okay, so we'll mark in here. So the sentence will be, a boy is holding the kite's string in his hand. Got it? Now we come to number 7. And number 7 is, there is a man sitting, S-I-T-T-I-N-G, sitting, in the bracket it is on / in a bench. Okay, I'm going to write a bench here itself, a bench. Okay, so when you sit on anything, you always sit on. As I told you here, when something is kept, it is on, and when it is not touching the thing, then it is over. So when you are sitting on a bench, then you are touching the bench, right? And then we say it is on. There is a man sitting on the bench. You can refer the picture. There is a man sitting on the bench, right? We never say in the bench. In means inside. For example, if I keep this pen on my hand, so this is on. Okay, it is kept. If I say in, then it will be like this. Okay? So when you sit, it is something like this. You are sitting like this. Sketch pen is on my hand. Similarly, a man is sitting on a bench. Got my point? It is not in the bench. We always say on a bench. Let's come to number 8, children. Number 8 here is, there is a bat. In the bracket it is written next, next to, / under, bracket closed, the man. Okay, next to means side mein, beside. You can say beside, baju mein rakha hua. Fine, under I told you it is niche, next to, baju mein, under, niche. So, can you see in the picture? There is a bat dash the man. Just now in number 7 we were talking about the man. The same man we are talking here in this sentence. There is a bat dash the man. Now as you can see in the picture, the man is sitting with a bat and he has kept the bat next to him. That is baju mein rakha hai, right? Niche nahi hai. It is not on the floor. It is next to the man. Got it? So the answer here will be next to. There is a bat next to the man. Okay, children? So we have done all the 8 sentences given in your book. So this was all for today, children. Thank you.